First, head on to this download page. The links are given in the description. Click on Windows 11 disk image ISO download. And now choose the product language. Now click on 64-bit download. And also you have to download a tool called Rufus. Head on to this site and click on the .exe download. Now I have this in this folder. Now I'm going to run Rufus. Plug in a USB drive and select it and select the ISO file. For this installation, I'm going with the MBR. And here you can set the volume label name. Let's give it Windows 11. And then click on Start. So we don't need these things, so we can just click on OK. And now the process has started. After it is done, close the application and eject the USB. Now start your PC with your USB drive plugged in, and you have to enter into the boot menu while it starts up. So you can choose the boot key of your specific device and choose the USB drive. And now you have to wait for a while. And now you get to this setup screen. Choose your language and click next. Click on install now. You can activate Windows now, or you can choose, I don't have a product key. Choose your edition. I'm going with Windows 11 Pro. Click next. So now we get the screen, this PC can't run Windows 11. So here, press Shift and F10 simultaneously and type regedit, which will open up the registry editor. And now you have to navigate to the local machine folder and there choose system and setup. Here you have to create a new key. You have to right click and click on create new key, and the key name should be lab config. The key is created, and inside the key you have to create a new dword 32-bit value and rename it by naming it as bypass CPU check. So we have to create 4 dwords in total: bypass CPU check, bypass RAM check, bypass TPM check, bypass secure boot check. And as you do all this, make sure to click on it and set the hexadecimal value to 1. Once it is done, you can just close the registry editor. And now go back to the previous step and click on next again. So now here we have the license agreement. You can just read it and click on accept and click next. So you can upgrade your Windows or you can do a custom install. So we are going to do a custom install right now. So you have to choose your drive, you have to format it and select the drive. So the system goes through several restarts during the installation. choose your country, choose the keyboard layout. You can add a second keyboard layout or just skip it. Connect to a Wi-Fi network or Ethernet, however you wish. And now you have to name your device and click next. And I am setting this up for personal use. Click next. And now you have to sign into your Windows account, Microsoft account. And I'm choosing setup as new PC. Now you have to create a PIN for your computer. And now choose your privacy settings and click accept. And now you can customize your experience based on how you will use your system. So choose what you desire your system to be. You can now connect your phone and PC. You can either accept this or click not now. Now the final setup begins, and then later your system will restart.